when United play Liverpool, for better or worse. The point is the people. Old Trafford trembles as once more the ancient tribal lines are drawn. Red alert. In May, they walk this walk to the whine of whirring police helicopters overhead. Now hear the thrillingly discordant Manchester Mersey mix. Perhaps the greatest player of this generation, probably the greatest player of this day. Ronaldo has achieved in our game what almost no one else has ever achieved. Salah is performing in our game like no one else can possibly perform. 20 times, 20 times Man United, but Liverpool, 19 times champions of the land, come here with hope in their throbbing hearts. Liverpool won here in May. United finished the season above them. So much of it is culture, civic pride, so much of it is history, current affairs. It just matters. It matters beyond reason. Last season, United knocked Liverpool out of the cup, but Liverpool under Klopp have never been beaten in the Premier League by United under Solskjaer. What a scene. And from either side of the most uncompromising sporting conflict, uncompromising human unanimity, no room for racism. So for the 100th time on United turf, red on red once more. For the world, on behalf of two wonderful cities in England's northwest, United and Liverpool again. Three meetings last season, United got Liverpool out of the cup. Liverpool took 4 points out of six in the Premier League, but those three meetings were empty and echoing. You heard the rattle of studs, you heard individual voices. Now it's a proper noise. We remember once more how United Liverpool should sound. And there's Ronaldo, and there is Fernandes! He's placed it wide.
A short time ago, Konate gave the ball away and then stepped out of position. Well, when he wins this, it was kind of weak in terms of what he was trying to clear. And again, it left a gap, which Manchester United were able to exploit. This has got to be louder than it was for Atalanta.
Firmino and Salah and Naby Keita! And Liverpool lead promptly on the turf of the enemy. The crazy corner is the Scouse corner.
Well, I think this shows you what is wrong with Manchester United and their weak defence at the moment. I mean, Luke Shaw has got caught. He's tried to step up to catch Salah offside, and in doing that, he's tucked in and he's just afforded the room for a midfield runner. That midfield runner was Naby Keita. And he had all the time in the world to be able to pick his spot, and there was very little David De Gea could do about it. And after Bruno Fernandes's miss, they've had to take that on the chin.
Rolled in with composure to uplift Jurgen Klopp. Five minutes in and United are chasing a game on their own ground for the second time in a matter of days, and they've lost it again to Naby Keita. And Keita has rolled it for Firmino, who is thwarted by De Gea. And United look nervous.
They do, and to begin with, I think it was a poor ball from McTominay to Fred. And it more or less set him up. There it was, and Keita's able to come in and nick it, and it's a lovely little feed to Bobby Firmino.
Welcomed in by Greenwood. Early ostensibly for Rashford. Last time Liverpool scored this early on this ground, Fernando Torres was the scorer, March 2010. United turned it round and won 2-1. Marcus Rashford! That's a threat.
Well, we were just looking at Naby Keita tucking the ball away. He just got caught here. Again, if you dwell on it in this fixture, then you're going to be shut down. And Marcus Rashford didn't catch it as cleanly as he would have liked. I think there's a little bit of ground before he caught the ball.
Robertson seeking out Jota. Maguire's lost it to Keita. And Keita's moved it on for Alexander-Arnold, and Jota has scored! Harry Maguire's misery. Manchester United's collective misery. Diogo Jota's joy. It's a way back for Solskjaer now.
Well, he went two down in midweek, Solskjaer, and he changed the formation to 4-2-4. And he might have to do so again. I mean, it's just a mess-up between Shaw and Harry Maguire. There's no communication whatsoever. And, his arm might be offside, but that doesn't come into it. Jota just holds his run enough. But that should have been more decisive from a United point of view in terms of how they defended it. They didn't, and they've been punished again.
There is an ongoing check here. Manchester United retain some hope that they may be let off the hook. But the check is complete, the goal stands. Diogo Jota has his fourth Premier League goal at the expense of Manchester United. Fernandes, Tomane, Lindelof.
Yeah, just listen to the frustration growing again now. Because it's sideways for the home side.
McTominay and Luke Shaw! Not a long way from the bottom corner.
Yeah, the home fans just getting anxious, but the width was with Shaw, the space was with him too, and that's really well hit.
Oh, that's Rashford's back pass, and Salah's onto it here for Liverpool. It's Mo Salah, De Gea saves, and it bounced kindly for Shaw.
Well, I'm thinking in that position, because it was so acute, I'm thinking Salah's going to try and go through De Gea's legs. He didn't, he lifted it a little. Yeah, and this is a mistake by Marcus Rashford, and setting Mo Salah on his way.
Saved by De Gea, who's kept just one clean sheet in now 12 games in all competitions this season. That at Wolves at the end of August. That was a clean sheet for which, if memory serves, he really had to work, made some fabulous saves in the game. Firmino, Keita. Dominate. Ronaldo. Bit of space here for Fernandes, bit of hope for Manchester United. Fernandes lifting it in towards Ronaldo. Robertson got a nifty little nick and kept it from CR7.
He's not the tallest, but he had to grow himself then to make sure he got something on that, because when you know CR7 is behind you, you can't take any chances. A nick, enough.
Robertson on stilts. Shaw with the corner, set for Maguire. Rashford was preparing to hit it, went for the same ball, Shaw went bludgeoning in, it's a goal kick.
Yeah, I mean, Shaw's claiming that it came off Keita last, but referee is not buying it. Yeah, it's probably the most uncertain moment we've seen really from Liverpool defensively, but eventually it's dealt with.
10 minutes out from half-time, at home, against the sworn enemy, and two goals down.
Well, I think what we've learned from what we've seen so far in this game is that Liverpool are the better team. We knew that coming into the game, and I think that's being realised.
Fred. Keita, he's lost it to McTominay. United could have a man spare here. Fernandes, that spare man could be Ronaldo. Konate can get between ball and goal. Shaw, Fernandes, beautifully cushioned for Rashford, who snatched.
He saw at the corner of his eye that Van Dijk was approaching, so that he didn't want to take a touch. but it's a difficult skill to get this right coming out of the sky.
Konate, cross came Lindelof.
Well, that was almost Matip-like, because we've seen Matip do that on quite a few occasions this season, step up and then look for that little incisive pass.
Keita, Firmino, Salah, Firmino, this is delightful, Jota and Salah. And here comes Naby Keita, Liverpool have three, it's Mo. Mo making merry at the Stretford end. Liverpool beyond their wildest, happiest fantasy are ripping up United on their own turf.
I mean, this is a nightmare for the home side, an absolute nightmare. And it's just like, it's controlled. And then once they get within the final third, there seems to be just a step up. And there's a fair bit of luck here, because it seems to have hit Harry Maguire and run very kindly into the path of Keita, who has been an offensive force for Liverpool in this game. But they're just quicker, more incisive in everything they're doing, and ultimately more decisive. And it doesn't get much better in terms of that decisiveness than seeing Salah do that.
On behalf of Jurgen Klopp, extraordinarily, Mo Salah scores for the 10th game in a row. Robertson. Away by Fernandes. Rashford into three additional minutes to give the game life, to give the contest legs. Ronaldo, Alisson, shut out the light. Ooh. Ronaldo went in, bullishly and had a kick. He had a kick. Initially a foul, that in itself perhaps worthy of yellow. But the second action from Cristiano Ronaldo is open to interpretation that could be fierce. Anthony Taylor buys himself time. Video assistant referee Stuart Atwell will communicate. It is certainly worth re-examination. Yellow card is out. And yellow card is shown.
Yeah, that's the foul. Now watch. That's a red card. I mean, that's just a blatant kick out at an opponent who's on the ground. Oh no, it's the ball. It's the ball. I beg your pardon. That's reflective of the frustration that is on the pitch and indeed off it.
Oh, that's a high foot from Fred on Keita, and he's going into the book as well.
I was just thinking Griezmann was sent off for a high foot in midweek for Atletico Madrid. He was always just bouncing away from him. I mean, there's no contact, I think.
Jota, Firmino, Robertson. Fiddled it through for Jota, and there's Mo Salah. It is four. It is four for Liverpool at Old Trafford. It's astonishing. For United, it is horrifying. It gets no worse than this. Given the context of the game, given the history of the game, given the meaning of the game, it is almost beyond cognizance that the scoreline before half-time in front of the Stretford end should be Manchester United 0, Liverpool 4.
Yeah, again, Maguire committed himself and didn't sort it out. He didn't deal with it. And it's great control by Bobby Firmino initially before it was helped on with Robertson, Jota. And again, I mean, we've seen Luke Shaw having to be tucked in so often, and it's afforded room to Salah and Alexander-Arnold and Keita. And again, Mo Salah ends up in that position. Time, space, goal.
Hear that. Hear that. That's the story. This is an horrendous walk for Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. There is no place to hide. Manchester United 0, Liverpool 4. What is there to add to that narrative? Self-told. cruel. He is ripped to pieces. For Liverpool, this is luxury plus. For Manchester United, boy, this is nasty. United 0, Liverpool 4 at half-time. Pogba has been a match winner, a match saver, a match turner. He has never had to turn a match to the degree that this one needs turning. A scoreboard the like of which Manchester United in the Premier League era has never known. Manchester United have never, never, since the birth of this league, trailed by 4-0. They do so now. They are in a place to which they are entirely unaccustomed. And whilst, Jim, we might say of lesser teams, we might, for instance, have said of Watford last week when they were trailing, go out and at least give something in the second half, send out a signal. Barring a miracle, almost whatever United do in this second half is...
They're damned. Yeah.
Yellow card for Bruno Fernandes for a foul on Jones right at the start of the second period. Henderson nicked it. Jota's one way, Salah's the other. He's on an Old Trafford hat-trick here, Mo Salah. And he captures the moment. The man is extraordinary. The match is extraordinary. The scoreline is extraordinary. That picture will be framed and kept forever by Liverpool fans all over the world. Another Mo Salah hat-trick. And this one, at the expense of Manchester United, at Manchester United.
Yeah, and Paul Pogba robbed of possession, which obviously ended up proving really costly. But what about the pass from Jordan Henderson? Outside of the right foot to get Salah away. And when you're running at that pace, you've got to make sure that you've got control of the football. And he did. He had exactly that, knew what he wanted to do. And the little lift over De Gea was perfection, and there's just no stopping the Egyptian king.
Last team to score 5 or more in successive Premier League away games, Tottenham, not so long ago, 2017, they got 6s and 7s at Leicester and Hull. But Manchester United supporters, many of them, have seen enough, and those who stay, well, Sir Alex Ferguson speaks for them. His body language is worth a million words. As indeed as Kenny Dalglish's. There's a screenshot for you, Liverpool folk, wherever you are.
Truly outrageous.
And the thing is, Salah's hungry for more. Forward by Maguire. Ronaldo. Just a moment, a smashing moment. It's a very, very good goal. Ronaldo doesn't really deal in consolation. He may have to today. He's just, I think, onside.
Yeah, Robertson looks like he's played him onside, and it was lovely little deft chip over the top from Harry Maguire. And that time he just gets his footwork wrong, Konate, and it affords Ronaldo a chance to just come in on that right foot and look for the curler. And once he gets in that position, it's hard to stop. And that is, well, certainly for him, at least individually, a plus.
There is a VAR check for offside. Oof. I'm afraid. Look at that, his back foot. Wow. Was the wrong side. It's offside. And not even consolation. I'm afraid we are going to have to tread into that trepidatious territory, that ugly conversation about Solskjaer and the immediate future. This is going to be a very tough one for United's hierarchy to tolerate, particularly if it gets worse still. Curtis Jones, Oh, that was a foul, was it, by Maguire retreating?
Yeah,
two issues here. One, which side of the line?
Outside.
Outside, I think.
Outside the
hence
box.
The free kick. VAR again checking just in case it was the other side of the line. It's nowhere near.
Yeah. But it's all too familiar. Liverpool players just marauding forward. And everybody now is hoping to get on the sheet. Yeah, he went through Jota to get to the ball.
Yellow card for Harry Maguire, Manchester United's fourth. They have four yellows, Liverpool have five goals.
And you know, as distances go for free kicks, doesn't come much better.
It's Salah into the wall, and Robertson, and Jones. What is the motivation for Manchester United over the last half hour? They're about to throw on Cavani and Dalot into a near impossible environment. And Bissaka has got them a corner.
Well, I guess the motivation is try and get something back without conceding another, without conceding a sixth.
Quickly taken corner.
That was firm.
Come up with the ball, but he'd left a stud in. And his name is taken. And this is worthy of a second check as well.
Yeah, it never goes down well. When it's straight in front of you like that, if you extend, and he's high, you know, he's a little high on Keita.
There is going to be an on-field review here. Anthony Taylor's going to come and have a look at the screen. Oh, my word. If Pogba goes, the headlines get darker. Darker and darker. A yellow card, by the way, means he has reached five and is already suspended. Never mind that. If this yellow turns red, this scenario turns ugly. Top foot's over the ball. Fear for Pogba, fear for Manchester United.
Yeah.
Paul Pogba will walk. Yellow won't do. Only red suffices. Manchester United trail Liverpool by 5-0. And Paul Pogba, their would-be talisman, is sent off. There were 70,000 plus in here. There are not any more. The car park's already emptying, the train's already filling. Not an empty seat in that corner, though.
Klopp is still berating his players. He is. He's still on their case. If they're a little out of position or not doing the right thing in a certain passage of play.
Henderson. Oxlade-Chamberlain taken up by Alexander-Arnold! That's a brilliant save. That is a brilliant save from David De Gea.
May have been the best we've seen this season. But again, he smelt the chance to just get onto it when Luke Shaw went to the other side. And oh, that is absolutely fantastic.
Carrick and McKenna. Mike Phelan. And Ollie Solskjaer at the top of that tree. They have got to motivate and make match ready. A team for Tottenham.
Yeah, I'm probably grateful that they don't have an EFL commitment in midweek, having gone out to West Ham in that competition.
United for a scrap. Poor lad. Poor lad. It's not why he came out today.
He's okay. I don't think he has a full appreciation of exactly what's taking place.
Maybe too young to hurt.
Yeah.
Bless him. Well, if he sticks with them after this, he'll be a proper football fan. McTominay's up across goal against the bar and out.
It's Cavani. I think it's Cavani got the touch that took it onto the crossbar. And McTominay looked as if he didn't want to go for goal, as if he was just happy to tee a teammate up.
What will he say? What can he say? What explanation is there? Liverpool's ultimate fantasy, United's utter humiliation. Barely digestible, barely comprehensible. A scoreline not just for a day, a scoreline for a generation, a scoreline for a lifetime, for the history of English football, a scoreline which will echo down the ages. Mo Salah scored a hat-trick, his day. Ole Solskjaer has it to drink in, has it somehow to interpret, has it somehow to react to. His job feels impossible. This for Manchester United was impossibly bad. Manchester United 0, Liverpool 5. It really did happen. It really did happen.